Hey everyone, it's Tom from HIDprojectors.com, and here's another extra video that we're doing coming out of our D2S projector shootout. We're going to compare the G5 projector, which we have here on the left, to the Morimoto 4.0 projector, which we have here on the right. So you're probably wondering, what are the similarities between these two? Well, in terms of performance, the G5 came in the hotspot measurement, which we did at 100 feet away. We used a lux meter using our Yeeky 4500K bulbs and our 35-watt Hella Gen 3 ballasts. The G5 came in at 54 on the hotspot, 54 lux. The 4.0 D2S came in at 62, so you've edged it out there by about 8 lux at 100 feet. In terms of the width, so then we took that measurement at 100 feet and went 15 feet out from either side. The G5 came in at 28 lux, and the 4.0 came in at 29 lux, so similar width performance. The 4.0 is going to be a little bit brighter on the hotspot. In terms of overall layout, they're similar in design, but different overall take. So you take a look at the back of the light here. You'll notice that the first thing to notice is the way these bulbs mount and the way that the actual projectors mount. The G5 has the clip-on or the half twist-on bulb here. So your bulb will slide in, you use this connector to twist the bulb on. The 4.0 has a screw-on projector with a spring inside, so your bulb will go in here and then it'll spring on. But in terms of the actual projector's output, they look very similar. Their footprint is very similar. The mounting points are nearly identical. If anything, you get a couple extra mounting points here on the G5. So you can see you've got three up here, two down here, and then you have these legs here too, which, don't forget, you may have to account for that. On the 4.0, you do not have that extra here, but essentially the same type of layout. So let's just pick these both up so you can see them both at the same time. And that's a pretty good shot there of what they look like stacked next to each other. So you do have the threaded mount on the 4.0, no threaded mount on the G5. You will have to do the nut and bolt method here or some kind of epoxy method to get those in. Both have a metal holder here for the lens. Both have a 3-inch lens on the front. The cutoff shields are different. Let's flip this one over. Got a curved cutoff shield on the 4.0 right there. You have a flat cutoff shield on the G5. In terms of the actual bulb design, you can see the optics here, I believe, are identical. If not identical, they're extremely similar. And you've got a black metal housing or lens holder on the 4.0. and kind of a natural metal holder here on the G5. In terms of price point, the G5 is going to be less expensive. Performance-wise, it's nearly the same. Certainly not as bright in the hotspot as the 4.0. In terms of overall mounting options, I think the 4.0 will edge it out because of the threaded shaft method. In terms of overall cost, the G5 will probably edge it out in terms of best bang for the buck, if you're willing to do the work to mount these properly. So I hope that helps you guys make an informed decision. With either of these great options, you do get a free pair of shrouds if you purchase them on our website. We're happy to answer any questions. You guys can shoot us a note. We're available sales@hidprojectors.com via email, or you give us a call, 716-662-3479. If you're ready to buy, head on over to hidprojectors.com. You can purchase either of these projectors by themselves in pairs, or you can pair them up with our ultimate HID kits, which come with bulbs and ballasts of your choice. So thanks for watching, guys. Please, if you have any questions, feel free to leave a comment below or reach out. We're happy to help you guys make the decision so you get the best projector for your money.